36 senators are calling on federal agencies to investigate the sale of Equifax securities shortly after that company learned of a massive cyber breach and before that breach was made public. As we've been reporting, up to 143 million Americans were impacted, and they're now worried about their personal data. Questions are also arising about loosely regulated credit bureau industries. Aditi Roy has our story.
Ashley Power is worried about someone stealing her online identity. She's one of up to 143 million Equifax customers who could be impacted by the company's massive cyber breach.
I think it's scary, actually, because basically a company's sole purpose to protect us and our information. If they're not doing that, then like who can we trust, right?
She's not alone. Less than a week after the credit bureau announced a massive data breach involving up to half the country, more fallout from lawmakers. In a letter to Equifax CEO Richard Smith, House Finance Committee Chair Orrin Hatch and Ranking Member Ron Wyden are demanding answers from the company, asking for a timeline of events and which executives knew what and when, including the three who sold shares after the breach was discovered. Equifax maintains the executives did not know about the cyber attack when they sold the shares. The letter also asked the company about an arbitration waiver that consumers agreed to by signing up for an identity protection package it's offering customers affected by the breach. The company said the waiver did not apply to the cybersecurity breach and has since taken the waiver language off the website. Equifax has lost more than $3.5 billion in market cap, or 21% of its value, in the first two trading days since the breach was made public. And the incident is also prompting many consumer groups to question the relative lack of regulation in the credit bureau industry compared to banks, which operate on charters and licenses and face constant monitoring by regulators. The class action suits are also piling on, with the company reportedly facing more than two dozen suits from plaintiffs. The highest profile ones include one filed by celebrity lawyer Mark Garagos and is seeking nearly $70 billion in damages, which would make it the largest class action suit in U.S. history. Another suit filed in federal court in Atlanta, where the company is headquartered, cites gargantuan failures to secure and safeguard consumers. One of the lawyers in that case is former Georgia Governor Roy Barnes. As those cases make their way through the system, consumers like Power are now wary of going online.
Just makes me question like everything I put online.
As far as what customers can do, consumer groups are urging people to get credit freezes so no one can open an account in your name. Make sure you get that freeze with not just Equifax, but the other two credit bureaus as well, Experian and TransUnion. The cost depends on the state you're in and can be between $5 to $10 per freeze. For Nightly Business Report, I'm Aditi Roy, San Francisco.